learn how to design this neat and this really stylish hand lettering vector design with today's Adobe Illustrator tutorial by Satori Graphics. Today's video is made possible by Namecheap, and I use Namecheap to obtain my most recent domain. Namecheap is used by web professionals, bloggers, startups, and also entrepreneurs alike. You can learn more about Namecheap later in the video and how to grab domains as low as 88 cents and also shared web hosting for under $3 a month. So yeah, welcome back to Satori Graphics, everyone. And for those really old school and diehard viewers of my channel, you might remember this kind of tutorial way back in my channel's history. Most people have not seen me talk about this, so I'm reinventing the tutorial for 2019. But yeah, you first need your typography, and you can either do this with a drawing tablet, or simply download a script font and then go up to type and create outlines. But when you have got the text ready, you can always adjust things really, really easy by selecting the individual letters and then coming over to the smooth tool. Now what the smooth tool does is it can eliminate anchor points or the use of too many anchor points, but it also can smoothen and round vector paths and vector corners. It is really useful, and this isn't necessary for this effect. It's just a really handy tool that I think you might want to be aware of when you're working on script hand lettering kind of typography. So as you can see here, I'm using the smooth tool to round off this A. And you can actually always press A for the direct selection tool and then drag down the anchor points to the kind of shape you want and then just smoothing it out with the smooth tool. But let's move on with this tutorial and let's create that really neat effect. So to join the entire design into one vector shape, we're going to open up the Pathfinder window. And by default, many designers will instantly jump to the Unite option in the top left corner. This will unite everything together as one shape, but once you've done that, there's no going back. So instead, before you click the Unite option, hold down the Alt or the Option key and then use it. This will create a compound shape where everything is technically united, but we can still go in and make edits. You can use such tools as the group selection tool, which would allow you to click and move different letters around after uniting them together. This is just a really good and a really professional and non-destructive way to work in Adobe Illustrator. So now everything is united together, we can make the background color for our design. And I'm going to go for a kind of reddy pink color for my text design today. And we're going to make a shape off to the side, just in case we want to refer back to the default color at any time in the process. So just press L or press M for a shape tool and just create a shape off to one side. Then press M for the rectangle tool and cover the entire artboard with a rectangle. Send it to the back, and then press Command or Control 2 to lock it down in position. I actually think this pink is too garish and too vibrant, so I'm going to change it down to a pastel kind of purple. So okay, we're actually ready to make the typography text effect, and to do that we first need to change the text color to the same color as the background. So use the eyedropper tool by pressing I, and then sample the background color. Press V for the selection tool to select and move your text around wherever you want to. We're now going to open up the appearance panel, as everything is going to be done in here pretty much. And you notice the fill colors here, and there's no stroke at the moment. But go ahead and select a stroke color, and I'm going to use black. The reason we use the stroke option in the appearance panel is because we can actually drag the stroke behind the fill layer, which is going to give the optimum effect for the hand lettering typography in today's video. A standard stroke in the color palette would not do the job. But you increase the stroke weight and you will see how the effect is going to take place. You will also notice some spikes coming out of your design. And to get around that, as well as having jagged edges, come into the stroke window and then round off the cap. So our design is starting to take shape, and this is pretty neat, but we're going to add some finishing touches using the pen tool. So for the next part of this tutorial, we need to use the exact same black that we did for the stroke. And to do this, come off to one side again, whilst having the design selected, and create a shape. Once you've made the shape, hide the fill and make sure you've got the black switched over to the fill. We simply need this to sample the exact same color of the stroke on your design. Now select your typography and press Command or Control 2 to lock it down in position. Then press P for the pen tool, and then press Shift and X to have a stroke selected. We're simply going to draw in some lines that will make the design look more interesting and to make it look a bit more 3D. So as you can see on this letter here, you can imagine the cross section overlapping the vertical section of the letter. And once you've made the shape, press Shift or X and it will flick the stroke over to a fill. You ideally want to spend your time creating small little details like this on your design. And trust me, it will pay off. It does look really good at the end result. But also take notice of your lettering as a whole and find some anomalies or unattractive areas of the lettering. Another technique that you might want to incorporate is to add lines and strokes around the edge of the lettering, just giving it that much more interest and emphasis. You really want to take your time and just, you know, experiment with things and let your creative flair blossom and flow. I purposely made a really ugly line here, just to demonstrate that you can use the smooth tool in this as well. It is really a useful tool, and I do like the smooth tool a lot, especially for this kind of work. I really hope you've been inspired, and also maybe you've learned something today. If you want to keep boosting your skills as a graphic designer, make sure to subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content. Like and share my videos on social media. And of course, until next time, design your future today. Peace.